Hello, my name is Juan Carlos Sayas, and this will be a short video tutorial on how to log into eLearner Network Services. The first thing we want to do is log on to the actual site, which is eLearnerNetwork.com. Once at the site, we want to scroll down just a bit and find eLearner Network Services. For today's demonstration, we are going to be using the Gmail app. You will notice that the domain name is automatically added after your username. Today we are going to be logging in for the first time as Aaron. Please make sure that you include the period between your first and last name. After using the default password, we are welcomed with the terms and conditions for using Google Apps. Towards the bottom, we type in the characters shown above in the picture. This is done in order to prevent spamming. After that, click on the Accept button. You will then be prompted to type in a new password. First, type in your default password, followed by your new password, which needs to be typed in twice. Once the new password is typed in, we click Submit. We can now start using our mail. On the right-hand side are settings which can be changed, both for Aaron as far as the privacy and account settings, and also for each of the apps we use. We do that by clicking on the cog. In this case, we have access to our mail settings. On the left-hand side, we have tabs, and for this demonstration, we are going to be using documents. Once we click on documents, we'll be prompted to see information on how to get started. Google Docs allows us to create various material. By clicking on Create New, we can choose to create a new document, presentation, spreadsheet, a form, a drawing, etc. For today's demonstration, we're going to create a new document. And the first thing we should do is give our new document a new title. Once we type in our new title, we click OK. This is our work area. And it should be very intuitive since it's very similar to applications like Word. Here we can start to type. Google does a great job of actually saving your work as you go, but you can always choose to click Save Now. Next to the Save Now button, we have our Comments button, and these are comments from people who have access to our document. In this case, no one has access to Aaron's document except for Aaron, so let's change that. Once we click on the Share button, we can use a link to share our document, or we can decide to add people within our organization that can have access to edit or even own our document. We do that by adding people, and we can give those individuals the right to edit, comment, or just view our document. We start by typing in the person's name that we want to grant access to, and these are individuals within the organization only. So let's choose one person, and since this is a group activity where there might be two or three students actually working on the actual document, let's choose two people. They will be notified that they now have edit access, and you can choose to email yourself as well. We now see the individuals that have access to your document. We can choose to make them editors, or just simply have comments, or just view access to your document. If we choose to delete access to an individual, just click on the X. We then click Save, and done. And that is how we share a document using Google Docs, and how we log in. Thank you for watching. Should anyone have any additional questions, please email me at webmaster@eLearnerNetwork.com. Google Docs is a great opportunity to share information amongst group learning activities, and it also does a great job of spell checking. Thank you for watching.